Hello, in this video I want to share with you my final thoughts about the Astronomic CLS filter, the filter that you can use to improve your astrophotography, which reduces light pollution in light polluted areas. And I will finally give you my verdict about whether this filter is something worth investing in, or maybe not really. So, let's get started, shall we? I actually have purchased this filter about 2 or 3 months ago, and I haven't been able to test this filter in the field up until like 2 or 3 days ago, because it was either cloudy or it was a full moon, and I was trying and I was planning and I was trying and I couldn't really get into good weather conditions. But I have actually made a 2 or 3 videos already on my channel about this filter, so if you want to check it out, for instance, you can click on the video right here to check out my unboxing video about the first thoughts about the build quality of this filter and how this filter feels in the camera, how to install it, etc. So check out this video if you're interested in details. But finally, I was able to take it out in the field and test it out in my city where I live. And I live in a pretty light polluted area. As you can see on the Bortle scale, it is like 7 or 6, depending on which part of the city. I live in Kraków, Poland. And by the way, if you don't know what Bortle scale is, I also have a separate video about this, how to use this and basically how to plan your Milky Way and nightscape photography, so you can check out the video right here. And also all sorts of astrophotography tutorials that are on my channel will be linked down below in the descriptions if you want to view more videos after you download this, of course. So to be honest, I was a little bit skeptical about this filter. I have read a lot of reviews around the internet that these filters are really more like a gimmick, they don't really help much, but they twist around the colors of the image a lot, so it's really hard to pull off any natural colors of the night sky in post-production. And I definitely agree with the color issues. I have tested this filter previously on my balcony when I couldn't really see the Milky Way because of the hill that was obstructing the view, but I saw the issues with the colors. The colors that these filters produce are very, very blue. They have a heavy blue cast and it's very hard to fix it with white balance. And I actually have found a workaround, and the workaround is to use custom color profiles, and also have a separate video about this. Again, link here and in the description. But 2 days ago, I went out into the field and I tested it. It was a beautiful night, it was a cloudless night, and I took 2 photographs. Well, actually, I have taken a few of them too in order to stack for post-production. But anyway, I have taken a photograph with the filter installed and without the filter installed, and I wanted to see back in the computer how much detail will I be able to pull out in those images in Lightroom and in Photoshop with the images with and without the filter. And boy, to my surprise, I have discovered that this filter is a real deal. I mean, with this filter I was able to pull out such an amazing detail in the Milky Way. Check out this image. It looks pretty good. It was shot from the area of light pollution of level 6 or 7, something like this, so it was a lot of light pollution, and look how the Milky Way looks. It's pretty awesome. And in comparison, take a look at this image which was shot without the filter, and I tried and I tried and I tried, and believe me, I wanted to pull out as much detail from this image as possible, but it was just not possible. It was just so much light pollution in this image that I wasn't able to separate the signal from the Milky Way from the signal from the light pollution from all the ground artificial lights. So this filter is definitely a real deal. I mean, it's a little bit pricey. It costs like almost 200 euros, at least this one. I believe there are cheaper alternatives on the internet, but this one I have tested and I can highly recommend if you live in an urban area or maybe suburban area and you're not really a fan of taking long trips in the middle of the night, in the middle of nowhere, in the cold when it could be potentially dangerous, and you want to do some astrophotography, then definitely consider checking out this filter, because like you saw in these examples, it really can pull out a lot of detail in the Milky Way, in the night sky, even if you're shooting with areas with a lot of light pollution. But beware of the color shifts issue. Again, check the video in the description if you want to learn how to deal with that. You can actually download my own custom color profile from EOS R in order to get somewhat natural colors to work with in post-production afterwards. So let me know what you think. What do you think about those two images? I can actually give you a link to the image that was taken without the filter, to the raw image. You can download it for yourself and try to prove me wrong and try to pull out more detail in the Milky Way in this image. I bet you wouldn't be able to get to the result that would be comparable with the result that I got using the Astronomic CLS filter. But that's it for this video. I hope you found it helpful. If you did, make sure to leave it a thumbs up and also consider subscribing to the channel, because there will be more astrophotography related content. And I also make here on YouTube all sorts of camera related tutorials like filmmaking, photography, Premiere Pro, Photoshop, Lightroom, etc. So if you don't want to miss out on future videos, make sure to hit the subscribe button. I upload new videos every single week. But that's it for now. Have a good day. See you next time and bye bye.